Sim. Eu gostei muito da gente ver assim. Aqui. Hello.
We are live now. Okay, just double check. Double check that it's going well.
Okay, 我看有办
Double
法。
check 一下下。Okay, great. It's live. Can you share to my hello?
OK，我看一下，我看能不能，我听到我自己的笑声。Oh my god！等一下，我 share。OK，OK，okay. Okay, 好。
有吗？有。
有。
OK, great.
嗯，对。OK，好。可以啦，应该是没有问题。嗯，
OK, 然后我先share to Room of Courage, sorry.
嗯，
Woman of Courage 在哪里？
WOMEN 的，那是 WOMEN 的。
他是 page 哦，我哎呀，I don't know. OK，Anyway，OK，
嗯。
Okay, we'll start the watch party.
我也是 start 了，我也是 start 了。
好，要把 logistics 做完没有？Sorry 啊。
没关系，我看我能不能，放一个东西，我忘记拿一个东西放这边。OK，看这样啊，这样能不能？OK，可以。OK，我好了。
Okay, 好，finally done all the logistic of sharing to the relevant page and profile. So, to Anna, 你好。
你
Yeah,
好，
so 今天你问的，你好。
你好。
Yeah, so 今天要讲 about what does legacy mean to entrepreneur Anna. So before 我们 go into the actual topic, I want to introduce Anna. She's actually a full-time online real estate advisor. She also is an author. She also is a podcaster. That means she actually record her voice and then this her story will be shared through podcasting. And she's also a business partner of a global business franchisee for anti-aging and weight loss program. 你看她这样美，你就知道了。Alright, and then 她 also did before the credit collections, where she hold 1,000 over files to advise banker on what legal proceeding takes. So 以前 right, you have done some legal advising paralegal before. Right, then you also worked in the bank before. You also was a insurance agent before. Okay, and then recently also obtained her life coaching cert from the New Skill Academy, and also going through the course of NLP. And next course she's going to take will be health awareness and child psychology. And then last but not least, Anna is a mother too and a wife to a lovely husband, also the eldest daughter in the family, have two other younger brothers and one younger sister.
Oh, 谢谢你，我没有 expect 我自己的 editing。哦
，professional，你很 professional，很 qualified。然后，我读你的那个你的 script 的时候，我说哇哦，真的很厉害。
拍谁拍
啊，
谁
哇，
，OK。
真的很厉害！你可以这么忙做生意，然后又顾孩子，然后还可以去上课，哇，真的 powerful，哎，
你
就
看，
做
你40岁了，就觉得好像有一点老了，
对啊，如果 it's always that hard，
不，会觉得啦，哈，人到了一个年龄，哈，我们的 clock 好像 tick 得特别快， 都要做的东西要快点做，不然等一下我没有机会了，担心
想做的东西就去做，对吧？
对对，
好，
特别想要做的快点做。
对啊，
嗯，
好，这样我们把机会留给你。Okay, so tell us more about yourself.
OK, 好，哎，等会我 share screen 啊，大家好。
好啊。
OK, 等一下，我看看能 share 得到吗？OK, 我要过去我的那个 OK, 看得到吗？有吗？看得到吗？
看
得到，看得清楚。OK, 好。OK, so hello everyone, I would like to introduce myself. So if you see, you can remember me or not. Do you want to build a snowman? Come on, let's go and play.I never see you anymore. Come out the door, it's like you've gone away. My name is Anna. So, Albana is correct. I'm also a podcaster, a co-author, full-time real estate online advisor, and the founder of Client-Centric Property. Okay.
Sorry.
So, just to share why I came into real estate, huh?Okay, so my background is I was born in 1980 and I grew up with Hong Kong movies. One of the movies that really deeply inspired me 就是这个叶德娴跟刘德华的《把内情》。
哦，我听你讲过嘞。You told me before.
Yes. Because of this lawyer, right, he managed to help this very deprived woman. Okay, who turned out to be a birth mother. Okay, so which...No, so it was then that I felt right, it would be so cool to be a lawyer. You can help people and make big money, and then you can help out with the finances of the family.
Mm-hmm.
So then I went to study legal studies in 1997, Temasek Poly. And my big why, all my life, right, I want to make a lot of money to provide for my family because I'm the eldest. So we're always worried about putting food on the table.Okay, I have three other siblings, like Alverna say. And when we were very young, we were, first time, we were chased out of our grandparents' house. And we were homeless and penniless. But luckily, that time, under the reign of Lee Kuan Yew, for the very poor family like us that time, right, there's abundance flats that time, really, for poor people like us to get a rental flat. So we got a studio rental flat in Telok Blangah.Okay, and then things later on improve, but one of my lowest point in life was in my early 20s when my parents divorced. Okay, so that time we had some financial struggles in the family with my parents, and then that time I was unmarried, and one day I found I only have left with $2.50 left in my MRT card. So at Raffles Place, 我哭到很惨。很大声，因为我觉得哇，如果没有钱的话、哦、真的是很 pathetic、哦。So forward in 2000, I graduated. And then after that, I started working as paralegal, serving a pool of 9 lawyers in banking litigation. 2002, I was a credit collections officer, which Alverna has mentioned. I actually was in a law firm holding 1,000 over files from an offshore bank, giving advice.To their bankers on what legal proceedings to go for delinquent accounts. 2003, 我就去了一个 offshore bank as sales executive for auto balance transfer. 2006 was my turning point because that year, before the CEA came in last time, we are able to do insurance and property concurrently. So then I was concurrently, but eventually I made a choice within 6 months.It was property that never made me look back ever since. Yeah. So my first year, what I got from real estate, right, was because of the help of my own knowledge and skills and experience. I managed to sell our HDB 23K above market value. It was a HDB house on the second floor, whereby the highest in the whole block is 18th floor. So on the second floor, 是最没有人要的啦。我们是飞速那个 mountain 的咯。Yeah, then you're your West Sun, but we managed to sell 23 above market value. And then at the same time in market, right, we also managed to purchase our first condo. That means me and my husband at about 165k below valuation.
哇！
这对我们来讲真的是一个很大的 God blessing. Yeah, because we really pray for it, and then God really bless us when it seems almost impossible. So then, not only monetary gains that I got, but it was also confidence from the closing of my cases and through my client handling methods. So I found that, right, by applying real estate methods with sound financial calculations and proper financial planning, we can actually improve the lives of ourselves as well as our customers and people around us. And even for
kids,
yes, then for kids, university funds, retirement planning, even legacy preservation and making 都可以做得到。
对，
So 2018 I had depression due to some family matters. 2019 after I overcome and recovered, right, I decided to invest in myself again and business, and that's how client centric property was evolved. So client centric property 其实是一个 roll up mochi of 我的 paralegal credit collection auto loans 跟 insurance 的一个 platform 来的。
Okay, so 当时 when you know when you wanted to start your own client-centric property, what is the thing that pushed you to start up rather than working for somebody?
Okay, that means in 2006, how I came about to join this business is because prior to that, my last job work was in the banks. Before I came straight into real estate, right, was in the banks. So in the banks, we have a basic and we have a commission. Okay, so come by the point when at one point the bank actually was intending to cut off our entire department.
Oh, okay.
So, job instability. Because we also know that months back some other department was totally chopped off.
Okay.
Due to revenue not making it. So for us, right, after we've been in the bank sales for some time, we all know that. So what is the basic? What does it mean to you? If you're a salesperson, even though basic you will do, because you know that your capability can get you the commissions in. But you also know that when your basic is high, then your commissions usually is low. So if you want to earn the full commission, you have to go all out, just no basic. No? So for real estate, 没有 basic 的一个job or career. So to me, 就是 the sky is the limit. No? Yeah, the sky is really the limit. 你要赚多少就是赚多少咯。你能 close 多少就是赚多少。对, but of course, company will take some cut. Nah. From then until now, it's always been the same.
Okay, all right.
So,
yeah, continue. You have any more?
Yeah, so that's when my friend she was in the bank with me. She went to this real estate and she showed me the dollar. She said, you know, 如果你很饼的话哦，你这样饼的话，你应该 join real estate 哦， because the sky is the limit for you. Yeah, 只要我一定赚得到钱。So that's why I took the jump immediately.
对，我相信你是一个很 hardworking 的人。真的看过你做工，
谢谢你啊！
相信你的 business also very busy, right? Then actually, how did you balance your family or social and personal life?
Okay, the balancing part, I really have to thank my mother-in-law, who is not here with me now. She passed on earlier this year with the, after she passed on, with the help of Elvina, I managed to settle the funeral nicely for her. The thing is, prior to that, I would say it's more of a lot of help from my mother-in-law. She will come to my house, help me fetch my kids to my house, look after them, go through their studies with them, you know, make sure they eat enough, make sure they go and bathe on time, make sure they change, dry their hair, everything, make sure they revise for spelling, tests, and exam. So 这样哦，我才有的办法去放心去跑我的东西。
对
，Yeah. So the juggling part was really the other day someone asked me how about work life balance, right? So it's like you want work balance. As a working mother, we always want work life balance. But then again, there was one agent who came to ask me about this same question. So my answer to her was, there is no balance for me. Okay. It depends on what are your priorities at that time. If let's say, for example, example, a husband happened to be down. He is out of job. He has no income. He is depressed. He cannot work, right? And he cannot find a job. Then you, as a wife, right, the life partner, maybe you can take on the role to bring the bread home first. So then the priority that time will not be, I want to spend quality time, quantity time with my kids. I want to stay home and cook. I want to be a housewife. Yeah. So for us working ladies, I would say it's always juggling.
Juggling.
Yes, we really have to juggle. There are times that I can have time off from work, then I will stay some time with my kids, you know, play with them, have quality time. 如果做工起来的话, my mother-in-law that time will come in, or my husband will come in to help me with my kids. Going forward, if 真的到时候还是很忙的话, 不能的话, I need to run about all the time like before 的话, then 可能真的 a part-time helper or maid needs to come in already.
I see. Yeah. So what is your biggest challenge at the moment?
The biggest challenge at the moment is not to get too lazy at home, right? Because 我们现在 right now in this circuit breaker, so we have to be at home all the time. And then if your house is made too comfortable, you will feel like you want to rest, you want to lie down. But remember that this is not truly the time to fully rest yet. We have to portion our time. Have to be fair to the customers who place their trust upon you, to finish up the job for them nicely, tie up all the loose ends. And then at the same time, also know that, hey, you're at home, you cannot be ignoring your children or family all the time. All of them tell you that they're hungry and you still don't order food or make any food for them. So all that's right. The challenge of really facing it head on with the juggling of all the duties all at the same time. Yeah.
So you have you finished your slide sharing?
Okay, 等一下啊，我看一下。 Okay, so the focus of the class and treat blueprint is with sound financial calculation and financial planning and go in with the online skills and knowledge, which is very important now because of this circuit breaker.
Right.
A lot of businesses we are bringing it online. And then, so this is mainly to help my client with their retirement funds planning, children university funds planning, preservation and making of legacy, and achievement of the lifestyle dream.
Okay,
so recently and going forward, Alverna is correct. I just got my life coach certification, right? And then currently I'm also taking the NLP course, which is the neuro-linguistic program. And once done, in the pipeline already is, I will further on with this mental health awareness cert to be obtained and a child psychology study.
Wow.
Yeah, so coming to the end of my favorite quote of life is, you don't wait for things to happen, make things happen.
Make things happen. Awesome. How? So, let's come back here. Then, 我要问一下你啦, since you have so much of life experience, right? What are some of the biggest mistakes you have made? And then, what do you learn from it?
Some of the biggest mistakes, a lot of mistakes 都是 like, I wait for too long. Mm-hmm. I find that I wait for too long to take action. And there are a lot of times when I find that as I look back at my life, right, there's so many opportunities there, but I gave it up. Thinking that I cannot make it, thinking that I'm too small, thinking that I'm not good enough.
Mm-hmm.
So then later you, after you give up that chance or opportunity, and then you see someone less deserving, assume the post, then you realize, hey, actually I can't want that. You know what I mean? Like someone less, actually should not say less deserving. 这样讲很坏. Okay, it's more like someone with lesser skills or knowledge, they went for it. Then with a lot of, with balls of steel, they proceeded. So they got it. So I think courage is very important.
How? So the next question, you know, women's, how can we use women's strength as an advantage?
Definitely.
What do you think of using women's
strength as an advantage? Definitely we can. Okay, for example, last time I used to partner with some male colleague, right? Male colleague. And then there are times when my male colleague call me and say, Anna, can you accompany me to this owner's house for a presentation? Then mm-hmm. I ask him, why can't you go alone? Then he said, mm-hmm. oh, the owner is a single lady. So I'm afraid what? If I go, the owner is a single lady.
Okay.
So I'm afraid if I go Gu Nan Gua Nu, it's not very nice.
Oh.
Yeah. Right. So he prefer I go with him. And then there are times I ever encounter my partner, this guy, business partner, right? And he was trying to tell the owner something. But you know, when men to men talk, they are very harsh one, very hard one. So maybe okay. he will come and say, yeah, yeah. someone wants to see your unit. Like, can we see at 8 o'clock? No? Like that. But oh. but then the owner turned him down immediately. It's a family lah. The owner is a family, husband and wife. So they turned him down immediately. Then after that, my partner mm-hmm. said, how about we need the appointment? We need the appointment. So I will go in with the soft approach. So I go in and say, oh, Mr. Owner, you know why? Why we must have this appointment at this time? Why the buyer in request of for this? Maybe it's inconvenient for you. So as a neuron, sometimes we are not so just one focus, but we also cover all the blind spot and areas for the men. So maybe
so we cover their blind spots.
Yes. So eventually I got the appointment done. Then my business partner actually 是我的 mentor. 他就问我, how did you do it? How come you got the appointment I didn't get? So there was another time also. That time woman sort of 拆火了. Then we target at the same owner because it's in the same condo development. So he mm-hmm. went first to present. I didn't know. After he presented, mm-hmm. 他出来走了了, then 到我进去 present. After mm-hmm. 我 present 了之后, that same day I got the key. Then again he called me and asked me, what did you do to the owner? How come I didn't get the key? 因为他比我 experience 吗? You know? But sometimes mm-hmm. it's maybe 我们女人的那个 我们有一个 trainer 讲女人的 EQ 可能好一点
对，就是我们 soft 然后我们又比较 sentimental 我们又比较 you know 会跟他们好像他们讲的什么 story 我们会跟他站同线 然后会 empathy 然后我们会这样子 yeah 对。 So 男孩子就是不会这样细心啦 我们就是女人就是比较细心一点
男人就是 zoom in 重点的，但是女人就是会 OK 啦，这样哦，不可以，等我们这样哦，等我们这样哦，怎样我们都是要进去就对了。So the thing是 quite happy 啦 ，as a lady agent 啊，就是说，不是说我们用什么怪怪的 method we didn't，but we actually are able to like you say 咯 ，with more aspect like in terms of family sir, you know, in terms of this how your wife, how your kids, how 就是我们会去 border 去讲这些东西，但是男人通常就是 want appointment or not, want to see or not, you want to sell your house or not,
yeah, 那种，所以是很不一样的一个，是 build business, 我们是 build relationship, 所以我们 build relationship, our foundation is stronger. 对，我们是，我们也是有很好的
male agent with a lot of good relationship. Yes. 我是说, sometimes I do find that 我们有一点点占一点点的优势
okay.
Then also sometimes my my male owners 也是 family men, most of them are family men. Then they say, oh Anna, I give you the key, 我放心 因为 the last round 我把那个 key 给我的 condo 放 key 给那个 guy agent After that he found like cigarette butts, rubbish, in the house, then 忘记关窗, 雨喷进来, 可是 female agent, not me, but we'll kind of say female agent, when they went for viewing, they bring a broom, they bring a mop. I mean, actually, our job is not asam, but you know, they actually bothered, some of the female agent actually bothered to do that. Which I kind of also will appreciate, but for me, 我不敢这样做. So for me, it's a different way, but it's just that you see there is a difference. You don't really see AI agent bring mop 啦 bring sponge 啦 bring 东西去洗那个 unit 吗？
嗯，没有啦，但是男孩子都没有这样子做吧？
啊，so I don't know whether will they try after this. yeah, 就是这样子。So some differences 啦，肯定有。嗯，咦 ，Alvin 呢？听到你的声音了。
你做 agent for 几年啊
？Since 2006年，然后中途我有停3年半看孩子。
嗯，所以我现在呢 ，What is the most satisfying moment for you in your business 啊 ？Most satisfying moment.
Most satisfying moment 啊 ，in my business 啊 ，I would say, actually 我不懂，有很多 satisfying moment 呢 ，like when we manage to upgrade from a HDB to a condo without any financial help from parents.It's something achievement ourselves lah. That year when we did that, I was only 30 years old. Then I bought my car when I was like 28. So it's like 想到会发生的东西发生了 because 我从来没有想到会 upgrade. 我从来 okay when I married my husband, I told him, 我的 CPF 哦只有24,000，你的 around 22,000，因为他 NS 嘛，对吗？So, okay. 我就说对啊，我们不要太贪心，我们买 3 room flat 就好 ，our first HDB. Then he told me no 5 flat because property very low price. 我说你神经病啊，我们买一个这样大的，等下养不起，我们怎么办 ？It was really scary to see 啊，每个月还500多块那个时候 ，when 我们两个才 very young 嘞 ，then 又没有 parental support 那种，就是我们 both family 都 not well to do 那种 ，then 要。Come up with 一个 commitment every month, then 你看到那个物价是百多千那种几百千，你会很怕的嘞。So 那个时候 ，but 没有想到说，就是在2006年那一年 ，when I make the choice to become a real estate agent, and then later on, after the experience, and in 2010, after I helped quite a lot of owners upgrade and sell their property effectively, efficiently, then I said, hey, Kelvin.I tell my husband, Kelvin, we can look into it, you know. We can actually sell our house, make a profit, and we can even perhaps upgrade, you know.
Correct.
So we work out finances, then we realize that it is within our reach and is actually achievable. And after we went through all the obstacles and we handle it, right, then 我们就觉得说, wow, it's really a very happy thing for us.
Yeah. So now, it actually helps you with your legacy planning, correct? Yeah. So coming back to you know, what does legacy means to you, right? So you know you were saying that you can help your clients to plan their legacy using properties, right? That is like saving their money, have retirement fundings, you know, have education funding for children and all these. But you know, my work, right? I'm a care planner. I'm a last journey expert. So, in the view of legacy planning for last journey, what is your view on the on this as a legacy for last journey?
The legacy for last journey, 你的是 more of like, is it more for property or other things?
For last journey, 就是 for 那个最后一层啊, for 那个最后一层, the legacy planning, you know, okay. What do you think of it? Like plan in advance?
Maybe I share with you my idea. Recently, my mother-in-law,pass away. Okay, just to share with you a bit more about ourselves, we never thought she would leave so soon because she's always really healthy. So years back, we did ask her maybe buy a house or something cheap from government using CPF to pay, 因为也没有很多钱嘛，那个时候。是说我们没有这样多钱，不是说那个屋子不多钱，而是我们没有这样多钱。那我们就想说，一个真的很便宜的屋子，你 know， 收在他老来，他有地方住 ，then maybe 那时候他不用跟两个媳妇住了有摩擦 or what， then 但是如果万一他老了不能动了哈，要跟我们住 ，then 跟我们住 ，then 那个屋子租出去，他有一个 income 进来可以 help to pay for me and whatever 吗？但是没有想到的是说，人真的突然间先走， So at any point in time, at any point in time, to me, legacy planning, 我们不要等到最后一步. My experience of doing it for her, right? 不要等到最后一步你才来讲说, 我六十级了我才来做一个 will, 或者我六十级了我才来 look into 我的 CPF 有没有 nomination, 我六十级来看, 我的屋子是 tenancy in common 还是 joint tenancy, 我六十级了才来知道我要不要买房子. 有些人到了35岁、37岁、40岁 都没有房子. So, so to me, I'm very worried, 就是说, for them is that 到了这个年龄你没有房子, to you is very easy, right? If you're a single and you don't have parents and don't have kids, it's perfectly fine. But 如果你有小小的蛋, 就是孩子呢, people that you really love, right? You want to leave something for them. 你一直在外面租屋子, 但是你万一大树啊, 因为我们人死, 有几个 reason 死, first is 老死, 就是很晚了啦, 第二个是 我们病, 第三个就是 accident 咯, accident 几时候的吗, 对不对? So if we don't plan ahead for this unforeseen accidents, 就是说 if we never think of maybe put our name inside 这个 asset, a property must be an asset, you must find an asset property, not a depreciating property. So property 有 depreciating 跟 asset 的吗? So two classes. So 你要找到那个对的, so that 万一 touch wood, 我们走, 什么东西留给我的孩子? 但是 to me, legacy 不只是这样, 不只是你银行的存款, 不只是你的地币, 不只是你的屋子, 房子, 车子, 这些东西, 也不是你的游艇, you know? 也不是你的游艇, 土地, okay, maybe 你买的土地, 你 maybe 在泰国买了好几间 condo, 我讲的不是这些东西, 还有一个很重要的是, 你留下什么给你的孩子, to remember you by for your values in life.
对,
yes.
What is the legacy that's left behind? Is it a life coach? Is it a life experience? You know, is it something that's memorable to them?
Something you treasure, you give an heirloom. 以前的人喜欢给玉, 给金, 给什么, 但是我觉得, 金玉良言哦, 你不如留一本书给他。
对啊,
你不如你是对我们的 including your daughter. So you see, 你不如留一本你书, 你生命的箴言留给他。 Just like the Bible, you leave the testament behind. Right. Or maybe 你留一个 podcast, touch wood, 真的有一天不在了, 我们这些 podcaster 留下的是声音, whoever can benefit from it, benefit. 不只是我们的家人,
对,
来个是这样子,
传承下去啦,
对, you really pass on something good and you like and you treasure to someone nicely. Rather than 7031, 哎呀, 他在哪里有屋子, 他在哪里有书本, 他在哪里有什么, we make it easily consolidate 了, we can pass on.
是,
hand over nicely.
Hand over with proper instructions, 就是把 will 写好, 对吧? 对, 然后 hand over, 就是 with proper instructions, it's all written in a will, 对吗? So 如果 hand over without proper instructions, 他们只顺着要来去这边找那边找, 然后找很多地方找不到,
最糟的是人也问不到,
最糟的 important of writing a will.
对, 最糟的是 如果没有讲好的话呢, 子孙会抢, then 就很难看了。 对, 因为我们 our Chinese, we have this Hokkien saying, 秋豆老高山. So we have a structure for the tree, right? The big tree that's been sheltering. So when this big tree really, you know, 倒了, uprooted, then all the monkeys will run amok, and then they will start snatching each other thing and then be really unhappy. It's no longer like a family anymore.
Correct.
Indicate, oh, I give this to Alverna, I give this to Julia, I give this to 什么什么什么, 不用抢咯, 爸爸都讲好了吗?
对啊, that's important, 我觉得。
对的，谢谢你的分享。好，然后我们，
你有一个很好的 offer 要给我们的 audience, 对吗？
OK 啦，我觉得 OK 的 offer 啦，不可以讲说很好的 offer 啦。是 right now OK, because I see that a lot of businesses we really need to go online, whether we like it or not. OK, this circuit breaker may take longer than we feel it might be. OK, because this is a global pandemic as I see it. It may not just last just 1 month. It may go beyond that. So the way to survive for businesses is to go online. Okay, so now I'm giving a free Zoom class on how to host the Zoom, the basic way lah. So I'll be just sharing on the basic ways how to get your Zoom hosting done. Yeah. So that at least, because usually when you're doing a business, you will want to hold your meeting or you want to hold a conference, be it with your staff or be it with your customers. So now you cannot do face-to-face, ma. So you do it online. Yeah, but you see, as a whole,
face-to-face, 我看过两三个月都不能够 open up.
Yeah,
so 还是要 Zoom 的，对。 So I strongly encourage, right, 那些在 business 的 get into Zoom, 那些不是在 business 的 learn how to use Zoom, because sooner or later, 你是要用 Zoom 来做一个 meeting. 你买些东西可能都要用 Zoom 了。 Yeah, so it's... It's very nice of you, you know, you actually host a Zoom meeting to let people learn, you know, 到底怎样用啊, you know. So don't panic, everybody, there's help out here, we can always get help.
Yeah, because a lot of people, they will join in as participants. But really, if you ask them to host, right, they will be scared. How to? Yeah, so this is the help I'm giving now, 就是这样子.
对，很好，谢谢. Okay. 谢谢你今天的分享. Is there any more thing you want to add on?
If to connect with me, right, you can click on the link that we have provided. Yeah. Then if not, you can also go to my website, www.clientscentricproperty.com, and you can also find my podcast links and the link to buy my book as well, Voices of Courage.
Yeah, Voices of Courage.
Thank you.
好, 对。 share a preview with all of you is your relationship with time. So inside the preview, right, Lillian will be sharing about how to manage time. And then it will be hands-on activity. And then for me, I'll be sharing with you on the case study of having a will and don't have a will. Also, I'll be sharing with you on the misconception of will. So if you like to register, please click on the link at Eventbrite. And also, it will be on the 28th of May, 8 to 9:30. So since this period, right, it's actually a good time to upgrade yourself. You know, upgrade yourself, know how to manage your time. Actually, also know whether to write a will or not at this point of time also. Okay? Yeah. Although will is, you may not see it as an essential, but when things happen like that, as a click like that, you will find that, oh, how I wish I have a will on hand.
Yeah. So will is very, very important.
It's not difficult 啦, 其实 will 真的都可以自己写, yeah, 真的很多人不知道,
So Alberta has a course, I remember you have a course to teach about will writing.
对, I also have a course, then 就是我的 Care Planner course, 对, so 这个 course 呢, 也是会教人家怎样做一个 will planner, 然后也是 about last year planning, yeah, so a preview I will share a little bit as well. Yeah. Great. So that's all for our live tonight. Thank you, Anna. Have a good rest. 然后记得去做你的面膜. Anti-aging 呢?
没有没有，我在吃 supplement. Supplement for anti-aging.
你在吃 supplement for anti-aging 啦? Nice.
可以。里里外外都。
对，另外一个就是说复合，是吗？对，好了，这样我们就结束了。 Quan trọng nè, for audience, I'll be on live again on Friday to do a review and reflection for today's session. So tune in on Friday.
Okay.
Okay, now see you. Bye bye.